4 years ago, Donald Trump's brand was on the rise, going from the boardroom to the Oval Office. This morning, he's fallen back to earth, still desperately trying to cling on to the US presidency.
And meanwhile, President-elect Joe Biden is wasting no time, already getting to work, pledging to lead a very different government. For more, we're joined by former advisor to Joe Biden, Mo Vella, who is in the US state of Vermont this morning. Mo, good evening to you, your time. Morning, our time.
Oh, I think you owe me a bet, my brother.
You didn't bet the wrong way, did you, Carl?
No, no. What I did was I tried to make it interesting. Right. And anyway, so what Mo gets to come to Australia now, if it transpires that happens, and we still don't owe Mo.
Oh, we know. And Sylvia, I just want to tell you up front as my new friend.
Yeah.
Having to co-host with Carl, you should be demanding a pay raise. That's all I'm going to say.
The request has already been lodged, my friend. Thank you very much for being on my side. Hey, reaction to the result has been mixed. We've seen so much celebration in the street, but 71 million people voted for Donald Trump, Mo. This is a huge task for Joe Biden to unite the country.
Yeah, absolutely. Listen, in all seriousness, there's time to celebrate yesterday and a little bit more today. But now the work begins, Sylvia, honestly. And to your point, 71 million people did vote for Donald Trump. And Joe Biden's not naive. He knows we're very polarized. We're fractured and divided nation. And you know what? He's got his work cut out for him. But here's the good news, honestly. If there's any human being I've ever met in my entire life, he's the one that possesses the ability, the characteristics, and the traits to at least begin the process of bridging the divide. So I hold out that hope that meticulously over time he'll be able to
do. Do you know, it is, and we love America, but to see it, how it's been in the last couple of weeks and even the last couple of days, that division is really awful. It is part of the great democracy, the big, beautiful, and sometimes ugly democracy that is the United States. But, Mo, we've still got this legal action to sort through. This happens from time to time. And there's still a mountain to climb there in regards to that legal action, isn't there?
Well, no mountain, Carl. A lot of little itty-bitty hills.
Mm. Yeah.
Let me tell you, as an attorney, I will tell you this, and I lived through the 2000 debacle as Al Gore's senior advisor, and I'll tell you this. This is not 2000 again. These are little itty-bitty, what I call frivolous and nuisance lawsuits. Mm. It's his way at grasping at straws. They'll slowly, the courts will be kicking them out. There's no standing. And in our democracy, in our legal system, you have to have standing. And that means you got to present facts and evidence to support your allegations. Nobody's found any. I mean, did a machine break in one place? Probably so. Did somebody crumble their ballot by accident? Yes. Did someone sign in the wrong place? Probably so. Out of 270 million ballots, somebody probably signed in the wrong place or crumbled it or whatever. Yes, but that's not fraud and that's not widespread corruption.
So, Mo, can you give us, because this is unprecedented to an extent, what happens in the next couple of days and weeks in relation to this legal action? Prepare us for what we're going to see and the timeframes.
Yeah, he's already started filing these lawsuits in state courts in the states that he, of course, let me point out to my brothers and sisters in Australia, he only seems to be filing lawsuits in states where he lost.
Yeah.
Notice he doesn't file them where he won, right? That should tell you a lot right there. But what you're going to see is filing in the state courts in like Pennsylvania and in Georgia, maybe Arizona and in Nevada, again, states where he lost, Michigan, Wisconsin. And you're going to see his lawyers presenting what they believe is evidence. So far, we've not even heard of any. Not one person can name one incident that would result in any type of overturning of this election, especially nationally, Carl and Sylvia.
Yeah.
Well, there might be an isolated incident where they may retract a ballot or two. Maybe. But remember, we're also going to see recounts. So sometimes our laws in states across our country require an automatic recount if the victory is less than 1%, in some cases less than 0.5%. That's what we're going to see coming up here in the next couple
of
weeks.
Some tight, very tight margins there. While Donald Trump is digging in, Mo, Biden is pressing ahead. He says he's going to name his new COVID task force tomorrow. Yep. That's clearly his priority as the president-elect. But how does he instigate change with the approach to the pandemic when almost half of the nation doesn't really think it's a huge issue?
Well, those half that don't think it's a big issue are probably going to have a pretty rude awakening pretty soon, because here's the deal. It is a huge issue. We broke every record again the last 2 days in a row. Over 120,000 people infected. And we have continued to have people dying, Sylvia, in the hundreds every day. So how anybody could say this is not serious is beyond my comprehension. Mm-hmm. But Joe Biden's not going to sit around and wait to let those people dictate the future and the safety and the health of all the other wonderful people in our country who realize this is a very serious situation. It must be controlled. The economy will never be recovered if we cannot get the dadgum virus under control. And dadgum is not a bad word, just for the record.
Okay, so just until he is, until the inauguration, Joe Biden is the next president, I'd like to point out that I think that our bet last week was rigged.
Here we go.
I've filed an action.
Sylvia, can you reach over and just smack him?
She's done
I'd
that
love
before.
To, but it might risk my pay rise, Mo, yeah. And I think I'm a good position for that at the moment.
Sylvia, don't risk the pay raise I just got. Carl, you know, here's the deal, Carl. Now you have to buy me some Hill of Grace wine.
Okay.
Because you know, you lost my brother.
Okay. All right.
He'll buy it for you, but he'll drink it all.
Yeah.
So
I've
so been warned.
Thank you, Mo. You're a lovely presence, great energy, and we'll see you in the next couple of days, no doubt. We'll keep talking. Okay.